years, fishermen have employed the strategy of migrating to locations different from their normal fishing locations, so more fish can be found in these remote locations and market demand can be more readily met. As seen in this graph published by the United States Fish and Wildlife Service, fishermen are moving to more distant locations where they can find better supplies of organisms to fish. So next, from the perspective of innovation, technology has increasingly become incorporated into fishing practices. Published by the ICES Journal of Marine Science from Oxford University, this graph demonstrates how increased predictions made with the assistance of satellite technology have allowed for an increased yield of many species while fishing. These technologies allow for fishermen to get an idea of where large concentrations of species are located, so they're able to readily obtain them for fishing. Technology and fishing must be used to find the small populations of species that are remaining in today's fish. Now, it's also important to consider the idea that some have presented that populations of organisms in the Atlantic Ocean have increased because of the increased attention given to them, especially through the media. Now, although this may be true, this trend cannot be generalized to all populations in the Atlantic Ocean. But it can be said that due to laws set by federal governments and fishing corporations and fishing agencies, that maybe the population has increased. These laws refer to retention limits, and retention limits set a cap on how much can be fished in a certain amount of time. This graph shows that the 2019 annual catch limits set on the most popular species in the Atlantic Ocean. These limits are set blindly. They take into account market demand as well as population growth of these species. Fishing companies and fishermen want to be able to fish to the greatest extent possible, but the abundance of that certain species must be taken into account before doing so. So all in all, decreasing populations of organisms have caused many important changes, fishing being one of them. These changes hope to account for all economic and environmental needs while still considering the health of the ocean as a whole. Thank you, and what questions do you have?
All right, so two questions for you. You're gonna get out of the camera. What evidence did you gather that you didn't use, and why'd you not use it?
There is a source that talks about the social perspective of this issue and how some cultures prefer fishing as their, because it's their only source of food, and how retention limits set on their fishing practices limit them and they're not able to gain the proper food that they need.
Okay, and next question. If you had more time, what additional research would you conduct?
I would research different locations, not just the Atlantic Ocean, and how fishing practices have changed in those locations as well.
All right, thank you. You're done. Breathe.